and get married at a drive-thru with fries. Welcome to Primetime Country with Gary Chapman. Tonight, country music superstar Dwight Yoakam talks about his explosive movie career. And Country Music Hall of Famer Buck Owens tells how it feels to get a birthday call from 15,000 people. Plus, Tim Akers and the Primetime Country Band. I'm Barclay Randall. And now, a man who in 3 short days has become Mr. Las Vegas. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Gary Chapman!
Thank you very, very much. We're glad you're here with us, and thank you, ladies. How about a big hand for the baby twins? That's Ooh Baby. Here's Ah Baby right there. Ooh Baby. Ooh Baby. I'm loving this town. I'm loving my job right now, folks. You like my jacket? You like the jacket okay? Rip Taylor was here last night, and he let me borrow one of them, so it's, looks good, doesn't it? Doesn't it look good?
Yes.
Smells bad. Looks good. We got a great show tonight, folks. We got great shows all week long. Coming up, we got Randy Travis, Leanne Rimes, Clint Black, two of the best rodeo cowboys in the world, Roy Cooper and Strand Smith, going to be here tomorrow night. I feel like a lucky boy just being here. There's a machine outside my dressing room, right outside my dressing room. Every single time I put quarters into it, a cold, refreshing drink comes out. It hits every single time. How are they staying in business? How are they making money? I don't know. Speaking of lucky, let me tell you who's the luckiest guy in this town. While we were back in Nashville, we had a little contest, and the big winner won a free trip here to Las Vegas, lots of great prizes, and $5,000. Please welcome from Indianapolis, Indiana, Mr. Leroy Bryan. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Go ahead and have your seat there. I wouldn't leave that seat if I were you. I'd stay right there as long as I could. Now, after the show last night, you went out, did a little gambling, didn't you? Hit the machines a little bit. Now, you've never gambled before, have you?
No.
Never has gambled before. Check this story, folks. He put 2 quarters in the machine, and then he borrowed a quarter. He just won $5,000, and he borrowed a quarter. I can appreciate that. You're a frugal man. And by the way, there's probably an opening in the accounting department at the Dick Clark Company if you're interested. There's So you borrow this quarter, and on the first pull, guy wins $1,000. $1,000. Leroy's my man. So after the show tonight, Leroy, you gonna go out gambling a little more, maybe?
Yes.
Just a little bit.
Yeah. One thing.
Yeah. You need to borrow a quarter from me? Yeah, sure. I'll front you, Leroy. We'll split the winnings. How about that?
Yeah, we'll talk about that.
We'll talk about the split later. Okay. Well, country music has many different styles. One of the most famous is the Bakersfield sound. And the man that helped create that sound, Country Music Hall of Famer Buck Owens, is here. Yes. And our first guest picked up that Bakersfield torch and ran with it. He's got one of the most distinctive sounds in country music. I am thrilled he's here. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome Dwight Yoakam.
I'll be
country. Can you imagine getting a phone call from 15,000 people? Buck Owens did, and he'll explain what happened. And next, Dwight Yoakam explains how his movie career has blown up.
Welcome back to Primetime Country on TNN. We're here with Dwight Yoakam. How about it for this guy?
Thank you.
And thanks. During the commercial break, you were telling me your mom's a big fan of the show.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. In fact, I think that you hold a spot now in her heart that Ralph Emery may have held for a long time. And she really paid you a high compliment by saying that you're doing as superb a job as she felt Ralph is hosting the show.
Well, thank you very much.
Normally, I don't ever let them be in the front row. It's too distracting to have your parents in the front row.
Right.
My mother and her husband are down the front row.
Okay. Well, we need to get a camera over there. It's a big room. It'll take us a second to get there.
Anyway.
We've got to get a shot of them there. Now, you've got these two records here that I want to talk about. The one here, the Come On Christmas.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you very much. You have to say that in this room. This is the room that Elvis
was. Here in Las Vegas, you need to say that.
This is the room.
I know.
This is the spot.
This is the stage.
It's holy ground, man.
Viva.
Las Vegas. Yeah,
thank you.
We
don't have to really even say, articulate a lot of the words, do we?
No.
In the spirit of Elvis.
Seems to make it work. Do we have a camera anywhere yet? We could get a shot of Dwight's mom and dad. Come on,
somebody. Right. We can leave. We can leave it be. They'll get them at some other point.
Okay.
I've got a Polaroid I'll bring up later.
They'd get mobbed. They'd
exactly.
Get absolutely.
You don't want them mobbed.
We don't want that. And then this one. This thing, Under the Covers.
Yeah.
Took a bunch of great tunes. And it's,
thank you.
You know, anytime you do covers, we were talking about not wanting to improve on Chuck Berry.
Yeah, Chuck Berry.
Well, you're not trying to improve on anybody, but you're trying to pay homage to
exactly.
Him.
Exactly. Yeah, that's what when Pete Anderson, my guitar player and collaborator musically, he's produced all the albums.
Right.
When we set about to do this, it was an outgrowth of wanting to kind of expose the variety of influences that had inspired us musically.
Yeah.
And the Johnny Horton song I performed for many years in nightclubs, and I also used to do one. We debated on there were tunes that we couldn't do. You know,
right.
Couldn't you know, put all the songs we wanted to do on the album. And there's a variety of styles. And there was a point, you know, Buck and I have talked about this with radio, where in the '60s there was a certain harmony to what radio was playing. There, you could hear Buck Owens on the same station when I was a kid. That I heard the Supremes and I heard the Rolling Stones just ahead of the Statler Brothers, Flowers on the Wall. And I think that was healthy. It was a healthy environment for a musician to evolve in, and for a young person that likes playing and listening to music to be exposed to. And I think it's unfortunate that we're so segregated now. I'm hoping that radio opens up and embraces a variety of styles again. Again, the cornerstone of what I do will always be country music. We're in the studio doing this new album now, and it's a lot of stuff that sounds similar to the things that I did years ago, early albums.
Yeah, well, I look forward to that. Coming out in the spring?
Late spring.
Late spring, yeah. Okay. Now, you've got another career that has blowed up in your face here. Did you have any idea that this acting thing was going to take off like that?
Yeah, well, Knockwood. I mean, It remains to be seen whether...
No, man, you're great.
Well, thank you.
You're stinking great.
Well, thank you.
You're really good at it.
He was specific regard to Sling Blade. I owe an enormous debt of gratitude and always will feel that to Billy Bob Thornton for writing a brilliant role and for being part, allowing me to be part of a great movie.
Wonderful.
I mean, what turned out to be...
I got to tell you. My dad turned 66 this last November 28th, just, you know, a couple weeks ago.
Mm-hmm.
Guess what we did for his birthday? We rented Sling Blade and watched it. Now, he loves this movie.
Well, apologize on my behalf for how I behaved in the movie.
No, you were great. I tell you what, though, it proves that you got something in you in this field, because you're a likable guy. Extremely so.
Thank you.
And I hated you in this movie.
Thank you.
You were a mean
well,
man.
If it's any consolation, my mother hated me far worse than you hated me. Unfortunately, she was the one that paid the dearest price, I think, of all.
We got a clip. If you have not seen this movie, Run Like the Wind and rent it, or it comes out January 8th on video. But I want to show you just a little piece of this. Clay, could you roll that for us?
But I ain't your daddy. You just act like I am. And the other thing I say is, your buddy Carl here is going. We can't be no normal family with him living in a garage and coming in a damn bedroom at 4 a.m. carrying hammers.
Carl can stay if he wants to. Mama said that...
Well, I tell you, bet your mama.
Mister, don't you never lay another hand on that boy. You understand me?
Yeah. And he meant it. He meant it in a big way.
Yeah. Come in carrying that lawnmower blade.
Come in carrying a lawnmower blade. A man means it, okay? Yeah. That man means it. And you just got back from Hungary, is that right?
Yeah, yeah.
The When Trumpets Fade HBO movie.
Yeah, it's a war film. Actually, it's set in November 1944, and it's a fictionalized account of what went on with the 28th Infantry Division
right.
just prior to the Battle of the Bulge. And it was I was unaware of the specifics of this. And I think collectively we all tend to forget that after D-Day, it was not just a free skate for those soldiers. And it's about the fact that a lot of those soldiers died knowing that the war would probably end in 3-4 months. But most of them would not make it home because of the job that lay ahead for them. And it's about those unknown heroes that died at the very end of the war, tragically. Again, like I said, knowing the war was going to be over shortly. And I end up playing the battalion commander in this particular division. And he had the unenviable job of pushing a lot of those men to their death.
Knowing that they weren't going to come back.
Yeah, knowing that.
Well, on that happy note, we'll go to a break.
No. Actually a terrific experience, and it was my first war picture, and I really enjoyed.
That's great.
Really enjoyed the work over there.
Well, I'm thrilled you're here, man. You're gonna hang out all night.
We're absolutely.
We're gonna sing and play
and hang out.
Thank you, buddy. Thank you, Jerry. Coming up, the one and only Buck Owens.
Coming up, Hall of Famer Buck Owens reveals how a surprise phone call on his birthday made his day. That's next on TNN's Primetime Country. Primetime Country is brought to you in part by Wrangler Cowboy Cut Jeans.
Yeehaw!
Welcome back to Primetime Country here on TNN. We're live from the Las Vegas Hilton. Our next guest is one of the legends in country music. He's played everywhere, and at this point, he doesn't have to play anywhere. And we are thrilled the buck stopped here. Welcome back, Buck Owens.
Hey, I'm going to do you a little medley of 4 or 5 songs. Now, if you've heard of them, I want you to let me know, you know. And if you ain't heard them, I'd like you to lie to me. They're gonna put me in the movie. They're gonna make a big star out of me. We'll make a scene about a man that's sad and lonely. And all I gotta do is act naturally. Well, I'll bet you I'm gonna be a big star. I might win an Oscar, you can't never tell. The movie's gonna make me a big star. Oh, I can play the part so well. And I hope they come to see me in my movie. Then I know you're gonna plainly see the biggest fools ever hit the big time. And all I gotta do is act naturally. Together again.
Oh, you heard me.
My tears have stopped falling. lonely nights. They're now at an end. The key to my heart you hold in your hand, and nothing else matters now. We're together again.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. You know, I want to tell you something. The young man that is the, he's the MC, he's the honcho, he's, you know, he does all this stuff here. And I know, I watched him since he came on the show, and I think he's got some exceptional talent, and I know he also sings and plays the guitar a little bit, and I happen to know that he knows a few of these old songs of mine, and Gary, come on over here, please. Yes, give a nice hand if you would. We're gonna, Gary, let's you and I, you know,
are you sure?
Yeah, I want you to do that. Oh, yeah, you know. And listen, see, now let me say this. We need a guitar, you know.
Yeah, I got
that. Can I have a guitar?
Where's my guitar?
Well, I'm getting you a guitar. Just look, watch out. Look out there. See that light? Good. Okay. Hey, look here, look here. That's my guitar.
That is your guitar.
No. Gary, I brought this guitar for you.
What?
Yes, I brought that for you.
Well, No.
Yes, I did. And I'll work. Let's see, we gotta move this over.
Oh, man. Oh, I've seen these things for years. And this is one of the real, this is one of your, oh,
that,
I'm not.
That is it. That's one of it.
And you tuned it, look at you.
I tuned it in 1944.
I can't.
Let's, you know
Thank
what?
You.
Let's do, I know, how about let's do a little bit of this one?
You go, I follow.
Okay, ready?
Okay.
Oh, the sun's gonna shine in my life once more. Love's gonna live here again.
Yeah?
Things are gonna be the way they were before. Love's gonna live here again. And love's gonna live here. Love's gonna live here. Love's gonna live here again. No more loneliness, only happiness. Love's gonna live here again.
Hey, God dang, no problem.
You singing with Buck Owens.
Okay, let's. Hey, I got another one. How about this one?
Oh, it's crying time again. You're gonna leave me. I can see that faraway look in your eyes. I can tell by the way you hold me, darling, that it won't be long before it's crying time.
Now they say that
absence makes the heart grow fonder.
Tears only rain.
And the tears are only rain to make love grow.
Well, my love for you could never go to...
I'm giving him his own line.
Well, my love for you could never grow no stronger if I live to be 100 years old.
Oh, let's do another chorus here.
Oh, it's crying time again. You're gonna leave me. I can see that far away look in your eye. I can tell by the way you hold me, darling, that it won't be long before it's crying time.
I want to congratulate you. You just had a birthday not long ago. Had a big old party down there in Bakersfield.
Yeah, we did.
Now, I can't
believe, do you mind me telling people how old you are?
No, no, I'm 58.
He's 58 years old. No, he's 68 years old. You look great.
Oh, you're wonderful. Thank you.
Was it fun down there?
Yeah, we had a great time, you know. Johnny Cash and John Barry, a lot of the great singers.
Couldn't get any names to show up at the party,
well, Buck? No, we had a lot of people.
That's amazing.
Oh, there's lots of nice people came.
And didn't you get a phone call from somebody that wasn't able to make it?
Well, yeah, you know, there was a phone call that said, hey, Buck, this is Garth. And I said, why are you Garth? He said, you're going to be there for about an hour? And I said, yeah, I won't be here. And he said, I will call you back. And I said, call me back? And he said, okay. So about an hour, he called back and said, hey, Buck, this is Garth again. And I'm here at the Arco Center, and there's 16,000 people here, and they sang happy birthday to me, Garth, and all those people. The entire place. And so, you know, leave that to Garth, a very classy man.
You know what? We got, there's one that we have to do. I mean, I'm not going to demand anything from you, Buck.
No,
Buddy.
No. Yeah. Are we? We're going to do that? No. You know, should we? We ought to dedicate this to Cletus.
Cletus?
Can we do that?
Cletus T. Judd. Now, you're doing a thing with him, aren't you?
Yeah, we're going to do something with Cletus. Now, that's a big deal. But
can I tell you something?
Yeah.
Be very, very careful. Extremely careful.
I think so. Well, we'll do this for him.
Good.
I got a tiger by the tail, plain to see. I won't be much when you get through. Looks like I got a tiger by the tail.
Go ahead.
Hey, I thought the day I met you, you were meek as a lamb. Just the kind to fit my dreams plan. And now the pace we're living takes the wind from my sails. And it looks like I got a tiger by the tail.
You got it.
I've got a tiger by the tail. Plain to see. Won't be much when you get through with me. I'm losing weight and turning mighty pale. Looks like I got a tiger by the tail.
Beginning.
Oh, it looks like I got a tiger by the tail. Hey, yeah. Oh, we're ready for you.
We're gonna buy a bus and get out of here. Next on TNN's Primetime Country, Buck and Dwight are going to spread a little Christmas cheer. Welcome back to Primetime Country here on TNN. We're live from the Las Vegas Hilton, singing Santa Looks a Lot Like Daddy. Welcome back, Dwight Yoakam and Buck Owens.
Well, they thought I was fast sleeping. Thought I was tucked in bed. Hey, they never thought that I'd come creeping. Then I'd hear what they said.
Santa put his arm around Mama. And Mama put her arm around him. Santa looked along to Daddy. That I was gonna tell on them.
I never saw a dancer or prancer. I never heard the sleigh bells ring. I never saw the red-nosed reindeer sell on a TV screen.
But he sure brought a lot of presents. Santa Claus, he must have been. Sure
looks a lot like Daddy. Daddy looks a lot like him.
Well, Santa looks a lot like Daddy. Daddy looks a lot like him. It's not the way I had him pictured. Santa wasn't much in there.
Dick come down the chimney, so Mama must have let him in.
Santa looks a lot like Daddy. Daddy looked a lot like him.
Tonight's sweepstakes drawing, we'll find out right after this on TNN's Primetime Country. All righty. Welcome back to Primetime Country here on TNN. Our winner tonight, tonight's prize is this Sony camcorder, and the winner is Lewis Fishbeck from Yadkinville, North Carolina. Congratulations, Lewis. Tune in tomorrow, folks. We'll draw again. More great prizes, tons of fun, including, I think, a Yamaha guitar. Do the ladies have the guitar? Okay. You don't get the corner pieces, but you get the guitar. That's the way that works out. Man, this is a thrill to have the two of you guys sitting here. This is a wonderful thing. Right. And I know, you know, you inducted into the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
And you wanted to thank somebody that you forgot.
Oh, let me tell you. Well, you know, it finally happened. I got up there, and it was Jack McFadden, part of the band, and it was Harlan, and it was just everybody. And I was thanking them, and, you know, and my wife was sitting there right around. I got through thanking that whole bunch, and afterwards I just thought, you know what? I thanked everybody but my little wife. For 30 years, she put up with me, and I didn't get to thank her. And so I told her, this ain't exactly the same, but...
No, it's not the same. It's a much bigger audience here.
My little wife, Jennifer. Yeah, my little wife, Jennifer, she's sitting right there. Stand up there, sweetheart.
All right.
Let's see. Come on. Come on down. There that little thing is. Sit down. Now. Thank you so much.
Oh, you're more than welcome. Now, what's that? Did I miss something? I missed something. I love missing something. How's the Crystal Palace doing?
Crystal Palace is just doing wonderful. Matter of fact, we watch you all the time at the Crystal Palace on the big screens, and we see you there. And so if you make a mistake, everybody knows.
Oh, that's okay. I don't mind.
We honestly do. And the Palace is, you know, books a lot of people. Well, Dwight came up for the birthday thing.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. We're out for Buck's birthday. Marty Stewart and I. First time that Marty and I ever played together.
Yeah, first time you ever been on stage.
Now that sounds like a marriage made in heaven to me. You guys.
It was a lot of fun. We had a great time. And then Buck brought everybody out. The Derailers were out there that night.
Jim Lauderdale
was there. We just had a great time.
Next time you have to come.
I'd love
Bradley
to
Foster.
Come.
Going
through my...
Who was there, Buck?
And Buck's wife.
Absolutely.
Buck's wife.
Jennifer was there.
I don't know. She was there.
Okay. Well, thank her for everything from now on.
Everything.
Just to make up for it, yeah. Now, I just experienced something that just was, you know, borderline spiritual for me, singing with Buck. And I know that he's, you know, huge influence on you early on. Yeah. Dedicated an album to him, and one thing led to another. You guys have hooked up a lot. What does this mean to you?
Well, he's been gracious enough to allow me to sing with him and to come and be part of our records. Obviously, the most famous instance of that for me is Streets of Bakersfield. It's because of Buck that I found out about the song. He called me Dwight. Dwight, I've never impersonated you.
That was good.
So I do a pretty good, don't I?
That's beautiful.
Dwight, he said, I got a song for you, Dwight. he used to call me up, I'd get the machine and go off, and he'd say, Dwight, this your buddy Buck Owens. But he brought the song to me, and I'll be forever in your debt for that song.
I'll tell you something else. It could have been any other way if it hadn't happened when I told him would, right? I called him up on the phone. Well, we were coming to do the CBS thing, I think it was, right? And they told me to bring a song that about Bakersfield that Dwight and I could do. And so I found that one way back in an album from 72. And so I took it and we did it, and we got a lot of response off of it.
Yeah.
And so Dwight took it and recorded it, and I went down and sang on it, and I thought about it for a few days. He was contemplating whether or not he's going to release it or not, you know? So I called him up that one day, and I said, Dwight, I think if you release that, it'll be a number one song.
And better, he said, better listen, yeah.
And he said, you think so? And I said, yeah. And he said, well, thank you. He didn't say if he's going to do it or not. but
I valued the opinion.
Yeah. He might be. But, you know, it was great for me. Let me just say, it's not only been great for Dwight, it was great for me. When he came to the office that day, he was playing the fair. I went out to the fair with him. I felt an immediate kinship with him.
Yeah.
Him and his band knew some of my songs. It's the first time I ever got up like that with anybody, and it's the last time I ever got up like that with anybody.
Wow.
So it worked out well for me. And
But the honor was all ours, all ours, and you know, we only hope to honor him every time he allows us to sing.
And we were talking about the Crystal Palace earlier.
Yeah.
I know you had some video footage we wanted to show, just to let the people know what they can expect when they go there. This is a beautiful place. Roll this footage here, Clay.
It's a museum. And,
yeah.
And it's a restaurant.
Okay, that's the outside shot there.
And it's all kinds of,
there you go.
Wow, it's gorgeous.
Various different things.
Big enough, Buck? Do you think it's big enough?
Yeah, it's a big old place, but
you got a car. Somebody parked a car inside.
Well, that's one of those nudie cars, you know, and that's up behind the bar.
Yeah.
And it's a...
What's it say on the back?
Elvis.
Oh, doesn't say Buck.
No,
that's not the Buck.
Oh, one thing that's wonderful there at the Crystal Palace, they serve a particular delicacy that I thought we might enjoy together. Some of your Bakersfield biscuits. Dwight Yoakam's got biscuits.
Dwight Yoakam's Bakersfield biscuits.
Well, I gotta have one myself.
Our opening night, we started serving Dwight's biscuits, and
they're great.
It's a surprise.
They're
isn't
stinking
it?
Great. I don't know what I was thinking.
I
was prepared to really say they're great, but I didn't have to even act. It was wonderful.
No, it's a.
Well, everybody liked what
we did. We did them for Buck's opening.
Yes.
No, we're watching. Figures.
Anybody want a biscuit?
No one.
Incoming.
I tell you this. We started that night with them, and we've done it ever since. People love them.
This guy out here eating a biscuit.
It's good, isn't it?
See? I told you.
We started serving Buck's grand opening. It was almost an outgrowth of a joke. I thought, what can I do up there for Buck? And I said, you know, I've talked about doing a biscuit with this guy just as a joke almost. It started tongue-in-cheek, and we served them.
Yeah.
And they liked them so much.
2,000 of them.
Yeah, 2,000 of them. They liked them so much, we had to keep making them.
That's right.
Well, you're giving 24,000 of them to missions for the holidays. Well,
between the Los Angeles mission and... Well, it's just...
Yeah, I'm going to show you.
It's only, you know, an appropriate kind of... gesture that we're able to help on that day, maybe, you know, provide food for some people. And what better way than with that particular biscuit in it.
And doing
we're doing it at Bakersfield Mission also.
You're doing a concert December 21st?
Right, it's all tied into a benefit concert that ties into the presentation of the Christmas music. We really won't have another opportunity to perform this music until after Thanksgiving next year.
Well, bless
so
you.
We're taking the opportunity and doing it at Billboard Live in Los Angeles on the 21st of December.
I'll just say one thing, in case I don't get another chance to say it. I think this is an outstanding young man.
Oh.
He's an outstanding talent, and we're very lucky to have him.
Thank you very much.
I mean that sincerely. My hat's off to you.
Thank you.
Man.
I appreciate that very much.
Check this out.
You're doing Fender's doing a guitar, Buck Owens.
Check this thing out.
It's killing me.
It's going to have a brass little thing down there. In it.
Oh, it's gorgeous.
A brass
sparkles.
Yeah. That's coming out. It's going to be called the Buck Owens signature guitar.
Well, I hope they make a lot of them, because I must purchase one. They're fine, fine, fine.
I know a guy that's making them. Maybe we can get one.
You know somebody that can give me, like, a cut-rate deal on one, perhaps?
Well,
yeah. Thank you guys so much for being
here. Thank you.
This means a lot.
My pleasure.
Bless your
my pleasure.
Don't go away. Dwight's going to sing one for us when we come back.
You can contact Primetime Country on the World Wide Web at country.com, your personal source for all things country.
Once again, Dwight Yoakam. And immediately following us, we got a very special Christmas with Colin Ray and Pam Tillich. You don't want to miss that. All right, these things are far too fine to not let go. There you go. Good catch. Don't be a stranger. Go buy a biscuit. We'll see you tomorrow night. There you go.
Airline transportation provided by Southwest Airlines, the official airline of Primetime Country. Go places, see people, do things. With Southwest Airlines, you have the freedom to fly. Southwest Airlines, a symbol of freedom. While in Las Vegas, hotel accommodations provided by the luxurious Las Vegas Hilton Hotel. Gary Chapman's wardrobe provided by Dillard's of Las Vegas. Gary's boots provided by Lucchese Boots. Lucchese, a legend among boots.